So hit the bell so that you get notified when those other Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I am Ariana with Where Black Sheep Meets. And today I'm doing two more diamond painting reviews. And today's diamond paintings come from Diamond Art Club. Since I have a massive stash now, I went crazy. And I've been slowly ordering more and more and more different kits. And today I'm really excited because this is my favorite artist that they sponsor on their website. And I have two of her artworks. There is still one more that I do not have yet, but I do plan to pick it up in the future. But today I'm just gonna unbox them so you can see, of course, what they look like, because I know people love to see the unboxings. And I will do my full review like normal, where I will do the unboxing straight until it's finished. And then I will show you the finished canvas so you can see the contrast between the canvas without the drills and finished with the drills. Because sometimes I know that the picture does change, and when you see the canvas, to begin with, sometimes it's not the same as how it looks when it's finished. So let's not waste any more time and let's go ahead and open these up so that I can finally get started on them, because I've been staring at them and I've been wanting to do them, but I know I had to film the video, so I was just holding off. So this is really exciting for me. So the two Diamond Art Club kits that I have for you today are going to be Daughter of Moonlight and Sweet Purple. And she has such great artwork. I love artists that draw like this. And the artist is Chibimica Art. So like I said, she's got one more piece of artwork that she collaborates with Diamond Art Club that I still have yet to pick up, and it is a mermaid. But for now, I'm happy to do these two, and I realize now there's a theme with all the purple. And purple isn't my favorite color, but it is still really stunning. So for Daughter of Moonlight, it is a round with an AB, and it is a 47 by 57. And the Sweet Purple is a round with AB, and the size is a 42 by 49. So it is a little smaller. So the first thing I think will open will be the Sweet Purple, and this is the one that I'm super excited about. Definitely my most favorite of the two, although I love them both very much. And this box is their old packaging before their new packaging, where it tells you like it's round or square on the front and whatnot. So this is one of the older, not too old I don't think, but it is definitely one of the older packaging kits. All right, so to start off we have the toolkit, and just a real quick reference, because I'm pretty sure the other one is the same, but it comes with your pen, for some baggies, your squishy or grip, two of the heart wax. This one comes with a three placer, and then you get your boat. And then we have the canvas here. The canvas itself is super soft. I forgot how soft it is. It's like fabric-y almost. This one comes with the paper as well, so I can replace the plastic film if I don't want to have the plastic on there. This is a pretty good size piece, so we'll see if it matches the size of the canvas. This one comes with your pamphlet with how to diamond paint. And put those aside. And then this canvas is supposedly self-flattening, so you should just be able to leave it out and it'll flatten itself out. You don't have to roll it or anything, so we're going to try that this time. But here it is. It is super tiny compared to the other one I did. I guess not super tiny. It's still a good size. I feel like it's right in the middle. It's not too big and not too small. So this one, like I said, is an older kit, so it has a little bit of the older setup from what it looks like. So it has the picture of it here, and then this one has the name, the size 42 by 49, and then the number, the model number. It has the two codes here, so I like that. And then the bottom has all their social medias and their lifetime warranty there. So it doesn't have the name of the artist. She's my favorite on their site, so that is all right. I know who it is. But I am glad that they do give credit to the artists on their newer canvases. So this is the canvas. Everything looks really nice. These little wrinkles are the plastic, like last time. It's not the canvas itself. This back. Yeah, it's not the canvas itself. So we can zoom in so we can take a look at the symbols now. So like the last Diamond Art Club I did, this has very clear symbols. You can definitely see everything on there really nicely. It looks like a lot of the same ones from the last kit as well. And I want to say it's more color blocky than confetti. There seems to be like shapes of the same color or little sections of the same color. The only color blocky parts, or the only confetti parts I see, are mainly in like the eyes, where there's little bits of everything, the eyes, the eyebrows, and the lips. But everything for the most part has a sort of section of color. So there is a bead drills, and it looks like number one and number two are a bead drills. I didn't know there was two, but let's see. So I see twos and ones right here in the eyes. There's a little bit of twos and ones here around her face, a little bit. I think that's it. So that's only a little bit. There possibly might be more, I'm just not seeing them at the moment. Oh, and this canvas does have 37 colors. So here are the drills. It does have the name and the code for the kit on here, and then the AB. So just like the last one, it just has the DMC code on there, which will be nice. So if I have any extras or new colors, I can pair this up with my leftovers from the I Choose You kit. And I can slowly start growing my storage since these are also around as well. So let's just go through the colors real quick so you can see the variety that they have in this one. So the first AB color is the 141, which is the white. So once again, I'm getting this color again, like I did in the I Choose You. And there's a good amount here, so I'm sure there's more ones I'm just missing. But yes, this one does have the coating on it to make them nice and sparkly and iridescent. So that is the first one. The second AB is 127. And this one is like a light baby pink, and there's only a small amount of these, so this one definitely will only be going in a few spots, I think. But yeah, these are really pretty too. Definitely a very sweet color. But I'm loving the colors overall. There are lots of pinks. I'm loving all the pinks. There's purples. There's a couple greens and a few blues. And then one little bag of, is that the black? I think there was a black in here somewhere. Oh, maybe not. Maybe I'm just thinking of. There's no black in this one, but the darkest color is this, which is the 829. Otherwise, everything is very light. Oh no, the darkest color is the 939. And there's just a tiny bit of that, but there is no black in this one. Just lots of pinks and purples. I love doing really colorful kits, so I'm super excited to see how the colors pop at the end. So real quick, going back to the canvas, this paper does, I forgot to check, but this paper does fit pretty much perfectly on the edges. And there's a longer length at the bottom, so it definitely covers the whole thing with a little more to spare. So if I want to change it out, I definitely could do that with this. So this is Sweet Purple, so let's move on to Daughter of Moonlight. So this one comes in a much bigger box, and I had previously opened this because I stole the toolkit out of it because I was diamond painting with a friend and I needed another toolkit. So I just, at the time, this was the only one I had available, so I just snatched it from here. I don't think I put it back either, but it's basically the same thing as the last one. It had the same exact components with the three placer in it. Oh, so this one comes, I can tell the other one. Oh, I didn't even realize the other one came with this sticker as well with the key code on it. So I'm going to use this again by cutting out each of the little pieces and taping them onto my containers when I kit up, because this is on a sticker. It was stuck inside the box and I didn't even see it in there. It kind of blended in. But I'm glad it came with this. I didn't even realize. So same thing with this kit. It does come with this sticker too. It's a little banged up, but it gives you all the information and then the picture, and again with the key code on the sticker. So I will use these to kit up as well. So this canvas comes packaged a little differently than the other one, where it's by itself this time. All right, so let's check this out. And here's a flyer. Teaches you how to diamond paint. And just for quickness sake, let's just roll this one back. But this one should also be the self flattening canvas as well. And it is the same soft fabric feel. So pretty! Super pretty. So this one is bigger than the other one. Let's see, does she fit in here? Yes, she does. This one is a 47 by 57. So a little wider and a little longer. And this one is the old canvas layout as well, with the picture here, the name, and then the model number. You have two of the key codes here. Their social media on the bottom and the lifetime warranty. And once again, the canvas looks pristine. There's no wrinkles. It's all in the film. And once again, this one has the glitter on the background as well. There's glitter on it. So it kind of has its own sort of shimmer and sparkle on its own. You can see the symbols, once again, really clear, just like the last one. You can see here, this is her mouth. Everything's super clear. With this one, And with this one, they do use the same symbols once again that I'm used to seeing with their canvases. But like I said, everything's super clear. This canvas does come with 26 colors, so a little less than the other one, but I guess that's understandable since it's got a lot of big color blocked areas on here. And there are two ABs in this one as well, and that is the number one and number two. So the number ones, I see here in her eyes. There's some twos over here. Oh, the twos are in the lace work. All the lace work is number two. Oh, that's gonna be really pretty. Number ones, let's see. I see like little bits of ones. A couple more twos in here. Twos, oh, here's the ones. I'm looking for a lighter color. It's these like darker purple colors. So there's ones up in here in her hair. There's ones over here, down her hair more. Oh yeah, so there is some ones, but they're mostly in her hair and a little bit in her eyes. All right, so we'll put this aside and then we'll take a look at these drills as well. So with this bag of diamonds, it only has the canvas code and the AB on there with the Diamond Art Club. So this one doesn't have the name. In case you wanna write the name, you can do that if you're storing these separately. So real quick, we'll go through all of the colors so you can see the variety of colors in this kit. So the two ABs are the 128, which is this kind of peachy pink. It's a little more vibrant than the other pink from the other kit. Yeah, definitely more peachy pink, but this one has the iridescent coating on it. These are really pretty. I kind of really like these a lot. So these are the number two. These will be in all the lace design that was around the edges. So there's a good amount here. And the second AB is this light, light purple. And this one has the coating on it as well. And there's just a tiny bit of these. So like I said, that number one, there wasn't much. It's just in her little bits of hair and a little bit in the eyes. But it's this lighter purple. Otherwise, in this kit, there is a lot of pinks and purples like the other one, but these are more I want to say like muted pinks and peaches. There's a few of the vibrant pinks and purples, but they're not a lot. There is one bag of 310 in this one, so there will be a little black, and an 823, which it looks like a dark blue, so there is a dark blue in there. But otherwise, this is a really dark purple. I actually kind of like this, like a eggplant color. There's a vibrant purple there. Oh, there is one small bag of 939 as well. So this one definitely is very similar to the last one, just not as vibrant in the shades of pinks and purples. But that's okay. I think it's still going to come out super stunning. I guess we'll have to wait and see at the end to see how colorful this one is going to be. But I know I'm not going to be disappointed. It's still a beautiful piece of art. So that is Daughter of Moonlight. But we will go ahead and go through my time lapses of completing both of these kits. And then I will come back at the end for my final reveal. All right, everyone, I am back. I have finished both of these canvases now. So we will do our post review and our reveal of both of them, since once again, I rolled them up. So it's a surprise as much to me as it is to you. So let's go ahead and get into Sweet Purple first. All right. Now, although it had a lot of purples and pinks in this one, it still is very colorful. So let's go ahead, let's unroll this and see what we have. So here's the bottom. It's our shirt. Let's go. She is so fun. Look at that. She is super, super fun. I adore all these little girly colors. That pop of green is probably one of my favorite parts. I also really like her shirt. As much as I hate putting AB drills down because they're so finicky, trying to pick them up with your pens, and the wax is always getting stuck to it and whatnot. So as much as AB drills look beautiful, they're such a pain in the butt to place down. But I love what it does to her sleeves and her shirt. That is such a great little detail. And as much as I didn't see it when I was finishing this last section, it didn't look like much as I was doing it until you actually finish and step away and you can see it make created the stripes in her shirt. I love these little ponytails with the little tear ties in them. And I really love this little AB bangs that she has going on up here. I think those are my favorite parts. For some reason, this keeps reminding me of like bunny ears. And I wish she had one on this side. I mean, in the end, you can always do that yourself and add another bunny ear if that's what you want to do. But that's what it reminds me of. So it kind of throws me off a little bit because I want her to be a bunny. But yeah, no, look, even in the camera, now that I can see in the camera, these little ponytails are so cute. Her face in person looks super red, like a more, it's such a dark, dark pink, like it's kind of weird in a sense, like you wouldn't think it'd be a skin tone, but altogether, especially from this distance from the camera, it looks really great. But in person, like up close, just looking at it, you wouldn't think that that would work. It kind of, like I said, looks very reddish, like she's got a sunburn. And I understand the art, it's sort of like that in general, but like I said, it kind of tones out in the camera from what I can see right now. But this is so pretty. It is super colorful, even though I only used a certain palette of colors. And I'm so happy to have this. This is definitely getting up on my wall as soon as we get to our new place. So let's go into the little details, if anything, about this canvas. The canvas itself, it's a Diamond Art Club. So of course, it's a really great quality. I didn't have any issues, nothing with the glue. Symbols were all clear, the drills were great, which let's get into the trash drills and I'll show you all of my trash bits. Okay, so I have my trash drills here. So this is it. This little tiny bit here is all the little trash bits that were in this kit. And they were just like little pieces with knobbly bits. There was a lot of these little tiny pieces in this one more than anything else. A few little awkward pieces, and oh, don't look at this one if you have a phobia of holes. I'm glad that wasn't in the picture, but it's got like a million holes on it. Yeah, there was a couple of those that have the holes all over it, but otherwise this was all the trash. That was it, this little tiny corner. So that's great. These drills were really great. So these are my leftover drills. I didn't run out of any of them. I have plenty to put into my storage of extra drills for future projects and canvases. Okay, so I had a few that had a lot left over, like this one. This one had a ton. And This one had a ton left over. So I got a bunch of purple now. And then this one, 939, I got very close to running out of, and I used a little bit of these, but this one was making me nervous, and there's still a tiny bit. But yeah, this one was the one with the least amount left over in this kit that used enough, I guess you could say, because I mean, this is a small amount too, but there wasn't much of the greens that you used anyways. So yeah, here's some of the ABs that were left over. So I have a good amount of colors left, or a good amount of each color left. So that is the leftover drills. So once again, this canvas was great. I loved every minute of it. I liked how fun and playful it is, and that's about as much as I can say about it. So let's move on to Daughter of Moonlight. So my second canvas. Hey guys, this is editing Ariana, and I ended up losing the reveal and first impressions clip for this painting. So to summarize, I was pretty much saying I loved her necklace and the gradient background with the confetti dots, which was definitely my most favorite part of this canvas. And I think I was continuing to talk about the quality of Diamond Art Club. So now back to our regularly scheduled reveal. But I'm sure a lot of you that have tried Diamond Art Club would say the same thing. So if anything, this is more just to show you what the beginning of the canvas looks like when you take it out the box, and then how it looks when it finishes. And that's why I like doing this together, so you can see that, because people will tell you all day long how great Diamond Art Club is, but a lot of times you have to wait to see the finished product. And I think this really shows at the end like how great it really is, because the quality of the end result is beautiful. So the last little side note with this one is I'm just a little bummed with the ABs in the lace around the edges here, just because they're so close of a color that you can't even really see them. And I know they probably sparkle a little bit more. I wish that the AB color was different. I'm sure that's how it translates from the actual original art. But I just feel like the lace border doesn't translate well into a diamond painting, because I can't really see it. You can just see something shimmery, but you can't tell the detail of the lace decoration around the edges. So that would probably be the only thing I would change, is maybe one day I'll take off all of these color ABs and put a different AB. But that would be my only comment on the canvas itself. So let's go ahead and take a look at all the diamonds I have left. And I do have a comment on the drills in this one. So for this one, I just ran out of baggies. So that's why I still have some of it kitted up in my Elizabeth Ward storage, which, by the way, I love this. I will buy another one, but not at the moment since we're about to move. When we get there, I will buy another set of these, because I love kitting up in these containers. But here is the rest of them in here. Like I said, there's quite a bit left over with these as well. Here we go, this is what I was looking for. Here's my trash drills. And once again, this is it. This little tiny, tiny bit. This is all the trash that I had. And it's about the same as last time. Some broken ones, some ones with little feeds, maybe a couple holes on some with like a hole on it or so. But yeah, that was out. That was all that there was. So the one that had the most drills left over was 819. And you can see there's a ton of drills in there still. This was all of the background. So there is plenty of this to put away. The one with the least was 915, and this one I was using a lot of, and so I was getting nervous with this one. There's still a good amount, essentially, but like I said, it was used a lot, so it was making me nervous getting down to the bottom of the painting, and it was getting very low because this was completely filled when it was when I kitted it up. Now the only thing I noticed that was off with this was the 327s. And if I get you up close, you can kind of see that some of these are darker than others. And that was throughout. And it wasn't like it was a different, maybe it's a different DMC, but it wasn't in this kit. But there was some mixed in here that were slightly a darker shade. Let me see if I can find one. Here we go. I don't know if you'll be able to tell, but you can see that this one is darker than the rest. Hopefully you can kind of see that. And there's quite a few. It wasn't just a few of them. You probably maybe notice more later on, but yeah, you can definitely see now that this is darker than the rest of them in the bag. And there were quite a few in there that were like that. So I don't know if that was just a different dye lot, and maybe it's still the same DMC number, just a different dye lot, or if it was accidentally a different DMC color and it was mixed in together. I don't know, but it was fine. I didn't bother with it. I just made sure that if I was doing like an entire row of this color, I just made sure they were all the same purples. And then if I was doing individual spots with this color or one or two, then I would use it. Because in the end, it's all blended in anyways. It wasn't like it was a color blocked area. It was in little bits of confettied areas. So it wasn't a big deal to me. I just used them. But that was just something to note that I had noticed when I was working on this. And it tripped me out for a minute and I was a little confused. And then I just realized that's probably just an accident, or like I said, a different dye lot number. So bottom line, I'm so happy with both of these. Here we will put them side by side. And you can see they're both really great. I love this artist. So if you're thinking about getting one, I hope you do, because you will love it. Once again, I hope you enjoyed the beginning to end of these diamond paintings. If you're looking for a great company, Diamond Art Club, they support their artists. Chibimica Art, you can find her. I'll try and put some links for her down below so you can find her stuff. But thank you again so much for watching. And if you like these videos, please subscribe, because I will have a ton more coming up in the future. So hit the bell so that you get notified when I upload more diamond painting videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.